Is renting so let's go to the old question of renting versus buying. Is renting best or buying best? Should we rent a house or should we buy a house? And the question itself depends on the market situation. We have seen a lot of appreciation in the market prices of the house in the beginning of 2000, but then there was a lot of decrease in housing prices and later of in around 2008 or so. So let's begin with the example. So suppose if we have a 100K house and we want to rent it. So if we rent it, suppose the rent is $1,000 a month. So if the rent is $1,000 a month, then in the whole year we are making or we are spending 12K. And remember that this 12K is the total burn of the money. So we are not, nothing of this money is going into our bank account, or nothing is being built up as an asset. So it totally goes out of your pocket and it's gone, right? So suppose at this stage you also have $20,000 in your bank account, and you put the same money in your checking account. And as you know that even if you have an online saving checking account, the interest rates are about 1%. So if you take 1% of 20,000, it will be $200. So it will be 0.2K interest. So in that case, your total income from putting the 20K in the bank will be $200. So you can subtract that from the rent you paid. So your total will be 11.8K. So you spend 12K on the rent, but you also saved some money because you put your money in the bank and you got some interest. In the same case, now suppose if you wanna buy a house, so again it's a 100K house, and you take a loan of 80K and you pay a cash of 20K. So you have a down payment of 20%. So you did not, now you will not get this interest now. So there, so you will no interest income in this case, right? So now your 80K, and suppose your annual APR is 4%. So in that 80K, you have to pay a 4% interest, and that 4% interest would be 4 into it is $3,200. So it will be 3.2K. So that is your interest, right? And you just don't pay the interest rate, you also pay the property taxes. And let's assume the property taxes to be around 1.5%. So in that case, you also pay 1.5K of property taxes. So your total investment will be 4.7K in that case. And we are not calculating the amount of the mortgage you have to pay every month, because part of it will be interest, and part of it will be going back to your principal, and that will build up in your house as a assets. So we are just calculating the money which will be totally burned out, or which will not go towards your assets, and that will be 4.7K. So if you compare both of them, then instead of burning 11.8K every year, you're only burning 4.7K a year. So this is per year, and this is also per year. So this is the difference. And one more thing is that you can always use this money to get some tax deduction. And however, the 4.7K is much lower, so it's better to have a standard deduction. But if that amount would be much higher, then you can also save a lot of taxes on it by using a customized deduction. And so that's why renting will burn more of the cash, but buying is better. However, if the house price do not appreciate and you have a decrease in the house price. So suppose after you bought the house, now house price, there are two scenarios that the house price goes to 100, 110K, or house price can go to 90K. So if house price goes to 110K, then instead of burning 4.7K, you make 10 minus 4.7 is equal to 5.3K. So you made a profit of 5.3K. However, if you have a decrease in house price, then in that case you will have to add that 10 to your 4.7K, and that will give you 14.7K. So now you've burned more money as compared to what you were renting. But this risk is always there, and suppose if you are in a town where you wanna where you see yourself for long term, then it's always a good idea to buy a house, because eventually the price of the assets do increase. And even if there is a dip at some time period, in long term the price of the asset should increase, because the population is always increasing, the limited resources are always shrinking. So house or number of houses needs to be built more, because more people needs to live in, so the demand will increase, and therefore the price should increase. But if you do the mathematical comparison of how much money you burn in renting versus buying, so you can see that in renting you burn much more money as compared to when you do the same investment in buying a house. So I hope this video helped, and I'll see you again in the next video. Thank you.